The Calgary Police Service Homicide Unit has arrested two people who are now facing charges following the death of their 15-year-old son. At approximately 10 a.m. on Tuesday, May 7, 2013, police were called to a residence in the 100 block of Citadel Drive Northwest for reports of a deceased youth. An autopsy was conducted on the 15-year-old boy on Wednesday, May 8, 2013, but further tests were required. It was later determined the immediate cause of death was a bacterial sepsis from the complications of neglect and starvation due to type 1 diabetes. Our investigators confirmed the victim had been diagnosed with diabetes several years earlier, prior to moving from British Columbia to Alberta. However, it is believed his parents failed to provide him the necessary treatment. The teen's health declined to the extent that he was confined to his room and subsequently died. He was homeschooled and did not have a family doctor in Alberta. Although the motive for not providing treatment is unknown, we do not believe it was based on religious beliefs. A man and a woman were arrested earlier today, Tuesday, February the 18th, 2014. Charges of first-degree murder are pending. The names of the accused will not be released until they have seen a justice of the peace and the charges are formally laid, likely later today. At that point, the name of the victim will also be released. We would like to thank our partners in British Columbia, including the RCMP Surrey Detachment, for their assistance in this investigation. And I'll take your questions.
Sorry, can you explain why the first-degree charge? Obviously, they have a history of not treating this.
And that's exactly what it is. This boy has suffered from long-term neglect to the point that he was unable to seek medical attention on his own. And it is their responsibility to provide that for him.
So would it be the planned and deliberation aspect of first-degree?
I think this boy was in a very difficult position over an extended period of time. And the ongoingness of it, the length of time that this has gone on for, I think is what has caused the Crown to, in consultation with us in the medical examiner's office, to determine this to be murder, and which is more of an extent than, say, failure to provide the necessities of life. In this situation, the details are extreme, and thus the extreme charge of first-degree murder.
So is it fair to say that they had been given notice that he needed to get medical attention? Like, they were well aware that he was wasting away?
We've had contact with agencies in British Columbia, and we're aware of this family's contact with them several years ago, between 10 and 15 years ago. And from that is included in part of our investigation, and to the point where we are today. So again, as I outlined in the release, this situation is not based on their religious beliefs. In this investigation, we spoke to members of, I'm not going to say several, but of different religious groups that these people had association with. All were very cooperative with us. In fact, it was people from one of those groups that urged this family to eventually call for an ambulance for this boy.
Can you, I know some of the first responders had to seek psychiatric services after this. Can you speak to the suffering that this boy endured?
Well, again, I think it just speaks to the extreme nature of this situation. And once we were inside the home, it was extreme. And so we did seek peer support and provided counseling opportunities for all of the first responders and anyone that was inside that house and saw the boy in the condition that he was found. Not at this time. It forms part of the ongoing investigation.
Have they been cooperative?
Again, they're being spoken to right now by investigators, and I'm just not aware of the details of that right now.
Can you elaborate at all on what happened in
BC? I really can't any more than I have, other than the fact that we're aware of it, and we have spoken with them and had a lengthy consultation with people in BC, but I can't really get into any more detail than that.
Is it known if between then and now the family had any other interaction with the
family? Again, these people did not, their children are not schooled in the public school system. They do not have Alberta healthcare doctor. So to that extent, they are not, they don't have a lot of contact with other people in the community and the public at large. So that's why I think this could go on for as long as it did.
How many other children does it have?
They do have other children. I'm not sure if I can specify how many they have. Okay, so I believe that the family, I'm just looking to the back here, I believe they the family has eight children, a total of eight children.
Including the one that passed away?
That's correct.
Do you have
age? I would say most of them are adult children.
Is it at all frustrating that there are obviously some steps along the way where they encountered either police or social services and this boy, you know, obviously suffered over a number of years? It could have been stopped before?
It most definitely could have been stopped before. And when you care for a child or a loved one and they're sick, you need to take them to the doctor. Home medicines and home thoughts don't substitute for modern medicine, especially in the city of Calgary.
What can we make of the length of time since the incident was first, the CBS was first made aware? Does this go to the difficulty determining which charges are appropriate?
Yes, it does. And after the autopsy was conducted several months ago now, it took this long for the doctors to complete all the tests that were required, to analyze the data that produced, to come to the determination as to what exactly did this boy die from. Again, we know that they had contact with BC, the BC RCMP, the Surrey RCMP, and BC Child and Family Services. But to what length? I'm just not well positioned to speak to that today.
Were they using alternative medicine?
I wouldn't say. That's hard. That's kind of hard to define. In this situation, I think, is more a situation of neglect than alternative solutions.
Like, was it something they were punishing him?
Again, that's hard to say.
If there were adult children living in the home, was there ever consideration charging them as well?
Again, this investigation has a lot of thought and effort has gone into this. We've examined all of those. We've had similar conversations, including those thoughts, with the medical examiner's office, with the Crown Prosecutor's office. And again, in consultation, we work closely with them on a regular basis. And when you examine all the evidence and facts that we have, the determination is that we will charge mom and dad with first degree murder.
And so at some point along the way, the family was notified, yes, he has diabetes. This is what it takes to treat it?
Yes. Again, that forms part of our investigation.
So just to confirm, were there any visits from social agencies in Alberta?
We don't believe so.
As part of your investigation, have you looked at possible neglect of other children in the family?
Again, we are obviously involved with this family to a great extent and have been for a considerable length of time. At this point, we're, I would say, satisfied with the care of the other children. And again, the other children, for the most part, they're getting to be adult children as well.
So there was no other kids that were being
neglected? That's correct.
Is there any indication of why he specifically was? Like, was it due to his illness?
There's no direct indication of that, but again, that's some of the same questions that our investigative team have. We're working on different theories to that, but again, it forms part of the information and the facts and evidence in this investigation. This boy was not cared for, and others in the family received more care.
Can you say how much he weighed when he was
young? No, I'm not going to. Again, that forms part of what we found inside the house, and I'm not going to speak to that. But obviously, it was extreme.
So was he the youngest of all eight?
No, he's not.
Are still other minor children. He was 15.
That's correct.
What happens with them?
They're in a safe place now.
Okay.